Okay, cool. Bit of a big announcement today. Drum roll, please. We're launching a new physical product. And I thought to myself, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to show you how to make money in e-commerce from start to finish. I talk about business a lot in some of these videos, so why don't I just show you? I'll set the scene. It's May 2016. We are located in Toronto, Canada, which means it is 11 degrees Celsius, i.e. 52 degrees Fahrenheit right now. Overcast skies, a little bit cloudy, and we just went out for dinner. We had Chinese food, and now it's back to work. I want to talk strategy with you for a second so you can understand what I'm doing here. We're launching a new product, and this is how I think about it. This is my understanding of successful e-commerce in three steps. Number one is that you need to sell something that people already need, something that's already making sales for other companies. So, online shoppers, how can you tell that they actually want your thing or not? I have two recommendations for you. You can look at bestseller rank, BSR, on Amazon. The closer to number one, the better. And you can also use the Google Keyword Planner tool to see how many monthly searches for the product there are on Google. So that'll tell you not necessarily who's purchasing online, but certainly the amount of search traffic is indicative to a certain degree of the online sales. Large platforms like Amazon and Google have tons of customer information, and all you need to do is know how to use it. So I would do research extensively prior to this. At this point, we've done our research and we know what product we want to go with. So, okay, sell something people need, but through a high traffic sales channel. You need to sell through a sales channel where buyers for your specific product are likely to be. Amazon is a sales channel, it's a huge one. eBay, Facebook stores, Jet.com, Craigslist, Etsy, your own e-commerce site, third-party online retail, flash sale sites, physical retail. Anything that attracts traffic and takes sales is a sales channel. You can certainly sell in your own online store, but why not take advantage of a channel that already has trust and millions of shoppers with credit cards on file? And among channels like these, Amazon is hands down the largest. That's why we're in the business of producing honest reviews for Amazon businesses in the first place. Sell something people already need through a high traffic sales channel with high margins. Once you've found a product with pre-existing demand, you source. You source it for $10, shipping included, sell it through a sales channel with traffic for 50, and you make 40. That's your takeaway. Ideally, you want to at least 3x or 4x your money. Make the product physically small and light. This cuts costs everywhere: shipping, returns, packaging, really everything. And most importantly, it should have the potential to be an aspirational brand, a line of products. One thing that makes a physical product worth more than its materials is the implied sense of identity that comes with it. So, anyways, I'm gonna get off my high horse. That's basically the strategy behind what we're doing. Back to the product. So, okay, this thing hasn't hit market yet. It's not on Amazon, it's not on our own e-commerce site, it is nowhere at the moment. So you really get to see some work that we do before launch. Here's what we've done so far. The product has been sourced. So we bought 1,500 units of a single SKU. That's the other thing. Avoid products with different sizes and colors, especially at the beginning. If medium black variation of the product is where 80% of the sales are, just stick with that and just make one to begin with. Multiple SKUs are a headache. So another thing about the product is that it is in the fashion space. And because it's in the fashion space, we had to get ungated by Amazon to sell there. So if you want to know more about the ungating process, leave a comment, like, and subscribe. And I can make a separate video about that if there's enough interest. And if not, I just won't, because to be honest, it's kind of boring. We've also enabled our account to sell on Amazon.com, .ca, which is home turf for us, and .com, Mexico. No, whoops. Okay, .com.mx is what it's called. Our plan is to focus on Amazon.com as the first sales channel and just optimize it, and then expand to other countries later on, CA, UK, etc., as we roll out our own e-commerce store and third-party retail as well. And you'll get to see everything. That's what's so cool about this whole process. I'll be filming approximately once a week, giving you progress and teaching you stuff as we go. It's fun. We paid our Chinese supplier by wire transfer. If it's your first time, I would recommend Alibaba Trade Assurance, but we've worked with these guys before, so wire transfer it is. And then it's been 4 weeks since we paid and production is done, so now it's really time to ship. And a little pro tip, if you could get your supplier on WhatsApp or WeChat, both of those mobile messaging apps that are popular in China, you'll be able to communicate with them faster than through email. Okay, so anyway, I did something a little bit new with this. I'm having our supplier ship directly from China via DHL to two different locations. We have 1,500 units, remember, so I'm sending 300 to an Amazon.com FBA warehouse for our Amazon launch and 1,200 directly to us so that we have some control over the distribution of the rest of the product. We've worked with these guys before, so I don't doubt their competence, but they've never actually shipped to an Amazon warehouse for us before, so here are the instructions I gave them. This is a screenshot of the email that I sent to the supplier, so you can kind of use this as a template or instructional, however you will. So we're sending 300 units, and Amazon doesn't let you send more than 150 pieces per box. So box one has 150 pieces, and you need a label for that box. Box two has 150 as well, and then on all 300 units individually, they all need product labels. So this is the stuff that you tell your supplier to do if you don't want to use a forwarder or an inspector or do it yourself or anything. I don't want to do the work, honestly. So I wanted them to label everything and send it directly to Amazon. If this works, then it's a huge time saver. And if not, then I'll need to dissect this and see what went wrong. But I've done this successfully before from China. I think it should be okay. Just make sure that you give them these bits of information. And of course, I've taken out the actual addresses, but the first address that they need is the Amazon FBA address, and then they're sending 1200 to our address. And of course, I've attached the labels as a PDF. It never hurts to have your supplier send you a photo, either by email or by WhatsApp or WeChat, because just to confirm that you're on the same page visually. It's one thing in text and it's another thing in photos. Okay, cool. So we're sending 300 to Amazon.com for an Honest View promotion. We'll promote probably like 100 to 150 units to get organic sales flowing in, and then sell the remaining half, like 150, naturally, organically, through pay-per-click as well. So we'll get into that. It's gonna be so fun, guys. You don't even know. Okay, so then 1,200 to our location so that we can ship to different Amazons like .ca, .uk, or online channels, depending on what's doing well for us. We'll follow the money in this respect. We'll just go with the channels that are performing well and cut out the channels that are not performing well. But initially, you don't really know, right? So you wanna try a few different ones. I'll eat some of the shipping costs any day in order to stay flexible around which sales channels to use. I was debating sending like 600 units to .com, but if for some reason it doesn't do well on Amazon.com, then I would have to pull it. So, you know, I'm just getting a lot sent here, and then I'll figure out the distribution shortly after that. All right, so, you know, what do you do? It's kind of like crickets right now. You're in the production and shipping phase. Well, normally I pre-market, and also you have the benefit of seeing a brand getting started from zero. So we don't have any social media presence, any web presence at all at this point. So I'm doing some pre-marketing. So yeah, most of my marketing efforts have been focused on Instagram. I'm building an Instagram audience so that when we launch the product, I can present it to them at a discount. Instagram is really where mainstream consumer attention is at the time of this video. Older generations are adopting it. It's kind of having its mom moment right now. And that's where my efforts are. My customers for this product are men, 25 to 55. They pay attention to how they dress, and they have some disposable income for gadgets, tech, fashion, crowdfunding projects, and grooming products. 3 weeks ago, I had zero followers. I have over 500 now. And when I use Instagram, I look for content that my target audience would like. I screenshot it on my phone. I repost with credit, and I use a few hashtags here and there. I think I could be doing better with the hashtags, but just being honest here. It's really not enough though to have an Instagram account and post stuff up and hope people are gonna find it. I engage them first. So I pair Instagram with Instagress, which is basically an Instagram automation software where you can like, comment, and follow based on certain hashtags that the users are posting their photos with. So I wanted to target people who had buying intent in their Instagram hashtags. I wanted people who would eventually buy my thing, right? And it starts not with the pitch, but who I'm bringing into the funnel at the very beginning. Here's some of the hashtags I chose. See if you can spot the buying intent. New suit, new wallet, hashtag new pocket square, hashtag new cufflinks, suit up, Fred Perry, and a bunch of names of subscription boxes. People who are buying new suits, wallets, pocket squares, cufflinks have just made a purchase, buying intent, and they're similar products to the one that we're selling. In addition, if you're hashtagging the name of a men's subscription box company, you're probably a customer of that company, and our product is quite similar and could fit into that portfolio really nicely. So these are not only my target market, but they're also people in the target market that I know have bought similar products. And that's the only person I want. Large numbers of followers on Instagram is a vanity metric. You want customers with buying intent. And of course, I'm not going to stop there. It's not just about followers. It's about converting the followers into paying customers. So when the product launches, I'll drive traffic straight to the Amazon listing. I'm going to point Instagram at Amazon with a link in the Instagram bio. I'll have contests, posts, giveaways, and some direct messaging stuff on Instagram that I will show you as soon as it happens. So we'll be pulling some customers in from Instagram, and in addition, we'll use Honest View to start getting organic sales off of the Amazon platform proper and grow that sales channel. So that's basically where we're going. Instagram marketing, bring customers in, also do a promotion with Honest View, bring customers in off Amazon itself, and grow the .com sales channel, expand out from there. I'm not focusing on our e-commerce thing. I want to optimize Amazon.com first, do well there, and reinvest some of the cash into new sales channels. So you're going to see this all live. This is the very beginning. So I'm so excited to have you here. I will continue this series as long as it's popular. Leave a like and subscribe if you want more of these, and I will continue to make them. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.